This guy may not be captain of the Millennium Falcon, but our next guest could build a lightsaber with his eyes closed. He's an elementary school teacher from Boston, and he's here to delight us once again. Please welcome Science Bob Pflugfelder. Science Bob.
Thank you.
How are you? Harrison Ford. Welcome. Thank you for coming.
Yeah, well, very exciting.
So what are we going to do?
All right.
What have you brought for us
today, Bob? Yeah, so we got a little bit of science. Thought we'd start with a little bit of chemistry. You guys like chemistry?
Yeah.
Yes.
Good. Yeah, get your goggles on.
Thank you for reminding us.
Chemistry is sort of as close as you come to magic, right? Sometimes it appears to be magic. So we got a couple of beakers here that are filled with various chemicals. This first one here is actually filled with a little bit of water, a little bit of sulfuric acid, and a little of potassium iodide. Now, don't get that in there. All right, so Harrison, if you want, you can take that little one that's got some starch in it, and you could pour it into this.
That's also sulfuric acid.
Yeah, you can just pour that right in there, and you'll see we get not much going on there, right?
Right.
A little bit of a blue color, because this is actually a reaction that requires electricity.
Oh.
A lot of people don't know. Yeah, you can take those batteries and drop them in there.
Okay, both of them?
Yeah, just drop them both in
there. Why don't we drop one each? How's that
sound? Okay, yeah, that sounds good.
Yes, all right.
Teamwork.
There's one.
All right.
Mm-hmm. And two.
Terrific. And so now we can turn this, and you can see the bubbles that are coming from it. Let's see if I can spin them around.
Yeah.
So what we're actually doing is we're oxidizing this chemical, and that is creating the blue.
You ever do that thing where you put your tongue on the 9-volt battery?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
That's great.
Why do we do that?
It is quite a thrill.
Yeah.
All right, so now we've got... Now, if you haven't tried it, give it a try. So now we've got this nice blue, right? So that's kind of cool. Now, this is an antioxidant. So that's actually vitamin C.
That's where blue comes from.
That's where blue is made, yes.
That's where the color blue was born. This looks like we should have combs in it, right?
Yeah. All right, so let's pour that into here.
Okay.
All right, because we're going to try to get the batteries
A
out.
A
right?
into B?
Yeah, like
without the batteries.
Yeah, without the batteries.
All right.
Pour that
is
in.
Is this dangerous at this point?
No, and see, the antioxidants are working and they reverse the action.
Wow. Isn't that without
cool?
the batteries, nothing
yeah,
happens.
That's kind of neat. So we got that nice little magical chemical change.
Uh-huh.
So now let's switch over. Now we have an acid here.
Yeah.
And I've got this red cloth that is stained with something called Congo Red.
Okay.
Which is also an indicator. So if you take that
mm-hmm.
and then dip it into this acid solution.
Dip it or drop it?
You can just dip it in.
Mm-hmm.
What
see?
Is it
and then we get our blue back. Watch, dip it in. Oh, look at that. Isn't that pretty? Go all the way in.
Not really.
All the way in. Come on, dip it in. Yeah, there we go.
All right.
There we go. So we got our blue back.
Okay.
So that's kind of cool.
Wow, it really did change colors,
yeah,
huh?
Yeah, actually changed colors, but the solution stays clear. All right, now Harrison, you can take that out.
Mm-hmm.
See, and then put that in here, and this has a base solution.
Uh-huh. You remember, he is a national treasure, okay?
Yeah, so I know that.
Okay, here we go. The base solution
is... All right, we give it a little stir here,
uh-huh.
and watch this. Oh, we get our red back. Ah, see?
Wow, yeah you're great. Right, that is red.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Now, if we want the best of both worlds, you can take that out of there, Jimmy, and squeeze it out into this one, which has a little bit of thymolphthalein solution, and then we get both colors, and look at that.
Wow.
That is the beauty.
And correct me if I'm wrong, but this is how they come up with the new flavors of Mountain Dew, right?
It could be, yes.
All right.
But wait a second. This is science, right?
Yeah, sure. It's real science.
This is science. Let me wipe my hand on this towel.
All right, we can take our gloves off.
Okay, take our gloves off, and what do we have next?
Let's do a little physics.
Oh, and this is...
Whoa.
This is, and correct me if I'm wrong on this is some kind of a sex machine, right?
Oh, no, Jimmy. No, no. So
let me correct you. You're wrong.
I'm wrong.
You're wrong.
That's probably for the best.
Yeah. All right. So what we got here is a 15-pound bowling ball with 3-inch spikes out of it. The spikes are a little unnecessary, but I thought they'd be kind of cool.
Okay.
All right. And underneath that, we have a ceramic pig, like a little piggy bank. There.
Yes, we've seen this. Right?
Yeah.
Yes.
So here's what we're gonna do. I'm just gonna make sure that's lined up. There we go. Okay. So we're gonna do first a test of gravity here. I want to make sure gravity's still working.
Okay.
So, Harrison, if you want to come back here.
Yeah, I'll take your glasses.
These?
All right. Yeah, keep those on for the moment.
Oh, all right. Yeah, keep them on.
Okay.
Yes, we must be safety first.
Now, this is going to be a little bit heavy. All right? So. Oh, goodness. Focus, focus. All right, here we go. So now, what we're gonna do is, on the count of three, we're gonna drop that, no, and we're gonna see how gravity affects.
That would break the piggy bank.
It might do that. Are you okay with that?
It's not my kids, so I'm fine
right.
with it.
Sure.
Here we go, you ready? Here we go. In three, two, one. All right, wow, there we go.
You're right, it did work.
Gravity works. All right, great.
We have an instant replay here we're going to look at, just so we can prove the effect on something heavy, on something fragile. Look at that.
All right. So now, we're going to do the same thing, but we're going to make one little change.
All right.
All right, so I'm just going to put about a 2-pound bag on here. That's the only thing we're going to change, but instead of a piggy bank, I went around your office today, and I asked him, what is something that is really valuable to Jimmy? And they came up with it over there. I don't know if you want to bring that over.
Oh, what is this? Oh, no. This is my Soul Train Award. You can't...
Yeah. So we're going to put that right down here.
You better not smash this Well, I won the Sims.
White person of the year.
Yeah, I won white person of the year.
When was that?
2015, yeah.
Yeah, it was a good year.
It was a great year.
For white people.
Especially this one.
Yeah.
All right.
Be careful, don't hurt
me. I'm hoping this means you're not going to break this.
Well, so here's what should happen.
Okay.
So I'm going to drop this again. But
you're
if all
drop
goes
it,
well,
yeah, I'm not gonna...
there's a little bit of nuance in this. There we go.
Now, this is the same length as the last time.
Same length. Everything's the same.
This doesn't seem like it's going to be good for me.
Now, if all goes well,
yes,
this bag will create enough centripetal force that it will actually, as it falls, stop it in the path.
Okay.
Then hopefully friction will continue to wrap around that upper pole and keep it in place.
If not, I am going to sue you, so let's find out.
I know. I'm a little afraid.
Okay.
All right, here we go. You ready?
I guess.
Three, two, one. Whoa!
Oh!
That was close!
You did hit it, yeah.
No, it's fine!
But it's fine.
It's fine! Fine!
It is unscathed.
Fine. All right,
give me that.
Oh, God.
No, you're going to drop it. Let's look at an instant replay to show what happens when something doesn't get crushed.
And, okay.
Oh.
Just a tap.
Yeah, you did come
just
a little
a
bit
tap.
Too close for my liking. All right, we're going to take a break. And what are we going to do when we come back?
I've done a little
something
bit of science
big?
And engineering, and it could be messy.
Okay, very good. We'll be back with Science Bob. Science Bob is here. Harrison Ford is here. We are we are doing fun things with science.
Yes.
And what fun thing are we going to do with science next?
We're going to take a quick look at some engineering.
Okay.
Back at my little shop, I have been going this ongoing battle with that sort of like party string stuff. You know, this stuff that you kind of you spray.
Oh yeah.
On,
oh yes.
Fun. Yeah.
Yeah.
So I figured, well, heck, I've got some engineering design stuff. I'll put it to good use. You know, there's engineers and there are innovators that are doing things to save the world. I just like building crazy things that make people smile.
Well, there's a place for that as well.
And so that led me to this. Oh, wait a minute. There we go.
The, what do you call this?
So this guy, instead of shooting one or two cans at a time, is designed to shoot 30 cans at a time.
So this is a real time saver, then.
It is really a time saver. And a lot of engineering, there's a lot of kind of mechanical advantages, there's a lot of testing. For example, these cans are only designed to shoot vertically, so we had to come up with a way to make them shoot horizontally. We had to make brand new nozzles for them. So anyway...
A lot of wasted time is basically what you're
saying. No. It's going to make people smile, right?
Okay,
that's
all right.
That's what it's all about,
okay,
right?
Okay, great.
All right, so I thought we'd test it out, and Guillermo was actually offered to be
Did
our
you
subject.
Offer this, Guillermo, or are you recruited into
Yeah, I did offer
You
myself.
Did offer it, all right.
So we don't want Guillermo to be completely defenseless, so here we got
Thanks.
Two.
Thank you, Bob.
For you.
Yeah. All right.
There you go. So those two are for you.
Okay. Right.
And Jimmy, so basically the way it works is you're going to hold that. You're going to pull that handle out. That will compress this whole front thing, and that should start the reaction.
Okay. All right. We do it now?
I think. You guys ready for this? Yeah! Here we go. In three, two, one, go!
I'm winning. I'm winning.
Careful. Careful.
Careful. Oh, no. There's another one. Wow. Wow. This is definitely Pflugfelder, everyone. Go to sciencebob.com for more information. Harrison Ford, The Call of the Wild. We'll be right back with Wiz Khalifa and friends. If you like that video, then put a ring on it. Click the subscribe button below.